Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today's tutorial is on this blown out, really like smoky cranberry look. I just wanted to play with this new color. I guess it's not that new, but this ColourPop shadow. Look at how pretty that is. This is in the shade Drift, and I really wanted to play with it. And I figured like a nice like blown out kind of like cranberry smoky eye would look really cool. So yeah, that's what I did, and I hope you guys enjoy it. If you want to find out how to get this blown out cranberry smoky look, then just keep on watching. Bye. Okay, so first I started out with IT Cosmetics Bye Bye Under Eye just to prime my eyelids, and I'm just setting that with the white chocolate shade from the Too Faced Chocolate Bar palette. And then I'm taking Makeup Geek Peach Smoothie and just using this Morphe M441 brush to put that into my crease, and I'm kind of making little circles on my outer corners. And this is just gonna help with that blown out look and just make everything blend together better and make everything look super smooth. And then I'm going in with Makeup Geek Creme Brulee, and with this Morphe E22 brush, I'm basically doing the same thing, making those little circles in the outer corner and putting this through the crease, and then also making little circles on the inner corner just so that everything is even on the outer and inner corner to make it more blown out and not like a cat eye kind of shape. So just doing that, and then taking my Morphe M506 brush and Makeup Geek Bitten, I'm just putting this in my outer corner, more defined than the other two shades though, and then through the crease and in the inner corner as well. And once you have like the base kind of set down with that shade, then you just keep on blending and blending and kind of pulling that shadow up, not really putting any extra shadow on the brush, but just kind of slowly blending it upwards and outwards to kind of blow the color out. And then taking this ColourPop Super Shock shadow in the shade Drift, I'm just using my finger and putting that on the lid. Usually these ColourPop shadows work the best with your finger, so that's what I did there. And then going back with that E22 brush and kind of just blending everything out and pulling the shades out and making it super blown out and blended. And then I'm taking my Makeup Forever Skin Equalizer Hydrating Primer, and I'm using this to prime my face today, and it actually works a lot better with the foundation that I'm using rather than the what's it called, the Nivea Men Aftershave Balm. This just makes it a lot more smooth and not really like patchy. With the other one, I felt like it was kind of patchy, but I'm using the Makeup Forever Ultra HD foundation, and yeah, I'm just putting that all over my face in little dots and then blending that out with my Morphe M439 brush. This is my favorite foundation brush ever. Blending, 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 and trying to kind of pat it into my face as well so that it actually like sticks down into my skin. And then I'm taking my Maybelline Fit Me Concealer and I'm just concealing underneath my eyes, and I'm kind of trying to avoid the eye area a little bit because I don't want to ruin that blown out look on the outer corners. So yeah, just putting that under my eyes and underneath my nose a little bit. And then I'll also be adding this on my forehead, down the bridge of my nose, on my cupid's bow, and on my chin. Basically all the high points of my face where the light would naturally hit. Just highlighting those areas and brightening up the look a little bit. And then taking my Real Techniques sculpting brush and just blending all that concealer out. And like I said, I'm kind of trying to avoid the eye area or the outer corner of the eyeshadow a little bit. And if I do touch it, I kind of try to like round it out near that area so that it doesn't like make an angle, you know, like I want it to be kind of rounded. So just doing that and blending all that concealer out. And then I'm going to be taking my Laura Mercier Translucent Setting Powder and my Morphe G2 brush and just setting all of that concealer. Thank you.
And then I'm just taking this little eyeliner brush and I'm putting that shade Bitten by Makeup Geek underneath there and just kind of connecting it to the outer corner of the upper lid. And then taking Makeup Geek Creme Brulee on the other side of that dual-ended brush, it's just like a smudge brush, pencil brush kind of thing, and just kind of blending that Bitten shade out a little bit. And then I'm going to take my Morphe E18 brush and Peach Smoothie and just blending that out even more and kind of trying to connect that in the outer corner a little bit just so that the lower lash line and the upper lid kind of flow together in that outer corner. And then just back into that E22 brush and just blending everything out. And then taking my NYX line matte liquid liner, I think it's called, and just lining the upper lid. I'm not gonna wing it out or anything. This is just to help with the false lashes that I'm gonna be putting on. So just lining that, just kind of a thin line. You don't have to go too thick or anything. And then I'm taking this CoverGirl Perfect Point Plus eyeliner, which I wouldn't recommend, honestly. It didn't stay on the waterline very well, but I just put that on my waterline, and then I popped on my Ardell 101s after applying a coat of mascara, which is the CoverGirl Full, no, not the Full Lash Bloom. CoverGirl, I don't know. I'll put it in the description box below. I'm blinking and I can't remember what it's called. And then just taking my Rimmel Stay Matte Powder and setting the rest of my face with that, just so that the contour and blush and everything kind of blends together and doesn't look so patchy on the face. So if you don't put powder underneath it, sometimes it can look a little patchy. And then taking Makeup Geek Shimma Shimmer, and I'm using this as my brow bone highlight and also my inner corner highlight on the eyes. And this is an old, like, e.l.f. brush, or not e.l.f., Eco Tools maybe? It's really old, but any brush will do. Just put it on the brow bone in the inner corner. And then taking my Benefit Hoola bronzer and my Morphe M530 brush and just contouring my cheekbones a little bit. And then also taking it up on the tops of my forehead like usual, like the perimeters of my forehead, I guess you could say. And that's really about all that I do with the contour. I don't really do my jawline too often, or I don't really contour my nose or anything like that. Kind of just keep it simple and just do my cheekbones and my forehead. And then I somehow got eyelash glue on my nose and I didn't even notice it, so ignore that. I'm pulling it off with some tweezers. If you ever get lash glue like stuck on your lid on accident, like on top of your eyeshadow, and it's not supposed to be there, obviously, especially if you're using like black, then just take some tweezers and pull it off instead of trying to like wipe it off and ruining the eyeshadow, you know? Anyways, I'm taking this Urban Decay blush in the shade Fetish and just putting that on my cheeks with this Morphe E4 brush, which is my new favorite blush brush. It's really, really soft. And then taking my Becca Shimmering Skin Perfector in the shade Opal and my Morphe M310 brush. I always say blush instead of brush, I don't know why. And just popping that on the tops of my cheekbones and around the temples of my head. And then I put a little bit above my eyebrows just to kind of add some slight shimmer to the face. I don't really add any extra product, just whatever was left over on the brush, and same on my chin. And then I use my finger to put some on the tip of my nose and the bridge of my nose, and then I kind of blend it out a little bit with the brush without any extra product again. And then I'm going to use my finger again and put some on my Cupid's bow and once again blend it out with the brush. And lastly, for the lips, I'm taking my MAC lipstick in the shade Velvet Teddy, and I'm going to be putting this all over my lips. And then to lighten it up a little bit and kind of get that ombre feel, I'm going to take MAC Cosmetics Myth lipstick, which is just a really pale nude. It's a really, really light shade, so I can't use it by itself, but it's nice to kind of lighten colors up. And I'm just going to be putting that in the center of my lips. And you'll see me do that in just a second. There we go. So that is Myth by MAC. And just putting that in the center of my lips and then blend it all together and you're done. And then here's just like a little overview of the entire look. I hope you guys enjoyed. Thank you for watching. Bye.
All right, so here is the final look. I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial, and if you did, please give it a thumbs up for me and subscribe to my channel down below. And you can see every time I post a new video. And yeah, follow me on all my social media. I have it all listed down in the description box below. My Instagram, my Twitter, which I don't use very much, and then my Snapchat, which you can see a lot of snaps of my little doggy. She's so cute. And I think that's about it. But yeah, like I said, if you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up, and I will see you guys in my next one. Bye.